part of history. Now it's time to make some of my own. It's time to go to work.
The following six-man contest is an Armageddon Hell in a Cell match. And approaching the ring from Grenoble in the French Alps, weighing in at 476 pounds, the eighth wonder of the world. And weighing in at 232 pounds, and from Paris Island, South Carolina, weighing in at 300 pounds, Sergeant Slaughter.
Oh my gosh, I can hardly.
From Cincinnati, Ohio, weighing in at 225 pounds, the Action Champion, Dean Ambrose.
I can't think of a time I've seen the WWE.
And approaching the ring, from Silsby, Texas, weighing in at 412 pounds, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Here we go. And before this match is over, I have no doubt that the Hell in a Cell will claim at least one more victim. Don't be surprised at all if these guys attempt to one-up each other in this one.
What's he gonna do here? What's he gonna do here?
Not today, too fast. John Cena delivering a blow there.
What do we got here?
There's not a lot of cushion for your...
Oh man, does he have that arm submission in tight?
If I had to suggest a strategy for someone going up against Goldust, I'd say it's imperative to not be adversely affected by his odd behavior. Goldust's unusual demeanor takes opponents right out of their game. An opponent will have to look past all that and focus on the match.
Oh, I agree, Cole. But you and I both know that's easier said than done. I think it's tough for anyone not to be affected by someone's antics who's known as the Bizarre One.
Tell us your thoughts about Goldust.
Looking fresh right now, which is good. You gotta wonder how much longer that can last, though.
Second, it's all academic from here. Goldust doing a great job of turning that around.
It's safe to say the entire WWE locker room has just been put on notice. Ow. There's a point where all of your training goes right out the window and you rely on instinct. After getting beaten twice with a weapon, you can bet this is one of those times.
King, we spoke earlier about a suggested strategy for an opponent of Goldust. That strategy has to be to focus on the match. Do not become frenzied because of Goldust's peculiar antics. Against Goldust, you can't get consumed in the bizarre world this oddity inhabits.
Timber! Hey, the shoulders are down!
Going for broke. The arm trap cross-leg STF. That'll do it.
That's the longest name in history. Arm trap cross-leg STF.
Who would do this? Who would do this to another man? Right to the skull, and now...
Oh, wow. He may have lost control. Somebody needs to get the sledgehammer away from him.
You know, I think sticking to any game plan against Goldust is a tall order. But to have a chance against him, you have to concentrate on the fight that's in front of you and not the freak that's in front of you.
And he's heading back. They're still alive.
Yeah, Cole, you remember that song back in the day? Staying alive? Well, that was it in WWE terms.
When this guy's on, look out. He's endured heavy blows here. I don't know how much longer he can go. The referee may have to call this match, King.
Oh, my gosh, this is awful. I'm going to tell you something. Whenever you get hit like that, for the next 15 minutes, everybody you see has an exact twin. Here's the cover.
1, 2.
We may have to worry about internal injuries.
Oh, man, how do you stand after an attack like this? The shoulders are down.
Looking to catch him off guard.
Quick ref count.
Oh, and he missed that one. God, that's gotta hurt.
Yeah, you're not doing any damage with swings like that, but keep the shoulders are down.
You know, King, every time John Cena steps into the ring, he steps into it like he is the C Nation's champion. Whether that's true or not, no matter who the opponent or what the reaction of the crowd may be, in Cena's eyes, he is the good guy in every match.
Well, you know that's usually the case, Michael. If Cena comes across as the straight-laced, small-town guy who just happens to be a dominant WWE superstar, well, that's because he is.
John Cena wants to end it here. There's the five-knuckle shuffle, folks.
Oh, that had to hurt right between the eyes. Way to go, John. How much damage did that do?
A lot, from the looks of it.
The shoulders are down.
1, 2.
King, we spoke earlier about a suggested strategy for an opponent of Goldust. That strategy has to be to focus on the match. Do not become frenzied because of Goldust's peculiar antics. Against Goldust, you can't get consumed in the bizarre world this oddity inhabits. He's making his...
Oh, how much pain is that arm in now?
And he lets him out.
Well, he might have been losing some of his grip there anyway. He
probably... A hip drop. The end is near.
I think the end is here after that. I don't like how slow...
And he goes for the pin.
There's the count.
And the shoulder's up now. That's a kick out.
Nice. Dean Ambrose is not going to go away that easy. When he gets going like this, there are a few better.
We're looking at complete domination here. God, there was... He goes for the quick pin attempt. There it is, the attitude adjustment.
Oh, the dreaded AA.
You know, I think sticking to any game plan against Goldust is a tall order. But to have a chance against him, you have to concentrate on the fight that's in front of you and not the freak that's in front of you.
Perhaps Andre the Giant has this match won now, people.
He thinks he has it. And it's Dean Ambrose able to break free. Bang, right to the face.
Seeing Goldust move like this makes it impossible to imagine that his WWE debut was back in 1995. Forget about swimming in the fountain of youth. The bizarre one's kicking tail and taking names in there like he's in a video game and has a cheat code.
Nowhere to go!
What a shot by Andre the Giant.
He wants this battle decided inside.
There's your winner, ladies and gentlemen.
I can't believe what we saw in that match. Look at this. And here's just, we got a couple of highlights here. Let's check them out.
Here's your winner.